everyone, Katrina here. Today I'm going to show you the four main rules of derivatives that will have you acing your calculus exam in no time. So when you take a derivative of a function, it allows you to calculate the slope of the tangent at any point along your curve. It's a very powerful technique that has many real-world applications across the world of science, finance, engineering, biology, and so many more. So let's take a dive into what the rules are. So we're going to start with power rule, then go into product rule, quotient rule, and finally chain rule. So let's look at power rule. Let's consider some function that we have, f of x equals to x to the power of n. The derivative of this function is denoted as f prime x. There are other notations, but this is the prime notation, which we will be using today to indicate the derivative. And following the power rule, we simply have n times x to the power of n minus 1. So let's look at a quick example. Here, if we were to have f of x equals to x to the power of 3, then f prime of x equals to 3 times x to the 3 minus 1, which equals to 3x to the power of 2. And that is the derivative. Let's look at a little bit more complicated example. So say we have 2x to the power of 4 minus 3x cubed plus 7x squared plus 93. In this function, all of our terms are separated by either a plus or a minus. So that means that we can apply the power rule individually to each one of these terms in order to find the derivative. So let's do that. So our first derivative of this function is going to be 2 times 4, x to the power of 3, minus 3 times 3, x to the power of 2. Then we're going to have 7 times plus 7 times 2, the power of x, and that times x, and then lastly, plus 93, what are we going to do here? So this term is the same as thinking of 93 times x to the power of 0. So if we follow the power rule there, then we're going to have times 0 to the power of x times x to the power of negative 1. So that means this whole term over here disappears and equals to 0. So that's something good to note, that the derivative of a constant always equals to 0. So let's clean up our expression over here. So what do we have? We have 8x cubed minus 9x squared plus 14x plus 0. So this is it. This is our final answer. We got the derivative using power rule. Let's move on and let's consider product rule. So in this case, we imagine that we have some function, we'll just call this big f of x, and it's equal to the multiplication of two other functions, some f of x times g of x. Then the byproduct rule, our derivative, f prime, equals to the derivative of our first function times our second function plus the derivative of our second function multiplied by our first function. So that's a little bit to remember, but I promise you'll use it plenty enough that you'll have it memorized in no time. Let's look at an example to help us clear this up. Let's say that we have our f of x equals to x to the power of 5 multiplied by 3x squared plus 1. So We can consider this first part to be our small f of x, and we can consider this second part over here to be our g of x. So we can see that we have two functions with respect to x that are being multiplied by each other. That means that we can apply the product rule. So a trick that I like to use is I like to find the derivative of my small f of x and g of x first on the side, and then I combine them later into the full equation. That way I don't make any mistakes along the way. So let's start with that. So our f of x equals to x to the power of 5. So how do we find the first derivative of this? We can see that we can use our power rule that we just learned. So this equals to 5x to the power of 4. Okay, now let's try our g of x. So g prime of x, we can also use the power rule to find because we have two terms that are separated by an addition. So over here we have 6x plus 0, because remember, the derivative of a constant equals to 0. Awesome. So now I want to take this and just plug it in to the formula here that I have for the power rule, for the product rule. So our derivative equals to f prime, so 5x to the power of 4 times g, which equals to 3x squared plus 1, plus g prime, which equals to 6x multiplied by f of x, which equals to x to the power of 5. Now let's see if we can simplify this any further. So this equals to, we're going to expand this first term. So we have 5x to the power of 4 multiplied by 3x squared. And then we have plus 5x to the power of 4 times 1. Now we're going to add our second ones. So here we can use exponential rules, which I showed in a previous video, to help us simplify this. So we have two x's, so the base is the same, and then that means we can then add the exponents. So then we have 6 multiplied by x to the power of 5 plus 1. Let's add this all together and see if there's any further simplifications. Okay, we have 15x to the power of 6, because I'm adding these exponents, plus 5x to the power of 4 plus 6x to the power of 6. And look at that. I have two terms which have the same exponent. That means that I can add this term with this term. This gives me a final answer of 21x to the power of 6 plus 5x to the power of 4. And there we have it. We use product rule to solve this derivative. Let's move on to the quotient rule. So the quotient rule is used when we have two functions that are separated by a division. So imagine in this case where our main function, large f, equals to some small f of x divided by g of x. Remember, g of x cannot equal to 0, or else this would be undefined. So let's look at what our derivative is going to be. So this is the formula. So f prime of x equals to the derivative of the first function multiplied by the second function minus the derivative of the second function multiplied by the first function, all divided by the second function squared. That's a bit of a mouthful. But once we have this formula down, we can use it simply to solve any derivative that are separated by a division. Let's look at an example here. Let's say that our function large f of x equals to x to the power of 3 minus 2, all divided by 4x squared. Okay, so we have identified that we have a numerator function, which is our small f of x, and then it's separated with a division, so our denominator function here is our g of x. So let's do the same thing that we did for the product rule and search for our first derivative of our f of x and of our g of x functions on the side. So f prime of x, again, we're going to be using the power rule. So that means we have 3x squared, and then g of x equals to 8x. Now let's just, g prime of x equals to 8x. Now that we have this, let's plug this in to our equation, our formula right over here. Okay? So let's see what we've got. So f prime of x equals to the derivative of the top, so our 3x squared times g of x, and our g of x is our 4x squared. Minus our g prime, which is 8x, multiplied by our f, which is x to the power of 3 minus 2. And all of this is divided by our g squared. And remember, our g is simply 4x squared, so we've got 4x squared all squared. Let's see if we can simplify this any further. So here we're going to have 12x to the power of 4 minus 8x to the power of 4, and then here we're going to apply this to the second term, so we are going to have plus 16x, all divided by 4x to the power of 4. And that is how we use the quotient rule to solve this derivative. We could take it a step further and factor out of 4 just to clean it up, so we'd end up with 4 and then 3x to the power of 4 minus 2x to the power of 4 plus 4x all over 4x to the power of 4. So these two cancel out. And then lastly, we can also factor out an x. So we have x, 3x to the 3 minus 2x to the 3 plus 4 all over x times x to the 3. So these two cancel out. And lastly, we see that we have the same power for these two terms. That means that we can perform this subtraction. So we will have 3x cubed minus 2x cubed, which just equals to x cubed plus 4, all divided by x cubed. And that's it. We've done this whole process to find the derivative using the quotient rule. So let's move on finally to the chain rule and see what that does for us in this case. So the chain rule is something that we can think of as an onion. You're trying to peel back all the layers of the function. So say we have some function, again, f of x. And f of x equals to some composite function where we have some f of g of x. So we have some function existing within another function. So how do we find the derivative of that? So we take the derivative of this function by first taking the derivative of our outside function, so our f, And then our g of x remains the same. And then we multiply this whole term by the derivative of our internal g of x. And this is one layer of the chain rule. Sometimes you can keep going if you have lots of derivatives to complete. But today we're going to focus on this. Let's look at an example, because this notation can be a little bit confusing. So say, for example, our function equals to x to the power of 3 plus 5x all to the power of 4. In this case, we can think of our f of x being almost like our x to the power of 4. And then our g of x is x to the power of 3 plus 5x. So essentially, we kind of take this whole term of g of x and we put it into where the x is in f of x. So that's how we have this kind of composite function where we have our f of g of x. So that's how we get this whole thing of x3 plus 5x to the power of 4. So we see how this function exists within this function. And that's how we have this composite looking function over here. So in order to take the derivative of this, we need to peel back the layers. So first we're going to take the derivative of f of x and leave our g of x the same. So that means we're going to follow our power rule. So we're going to bring down the 4. And again, what stays in here stays the same. X to the power of 3 plus 5x. And then remember, with power rule, we have to do 4 minus 1. And then now we have to then take the derivative of our g of x. So we multiply this by 3x squared plus 5. So then our final answer here is 4 times x cubed plus 5x to the power of 3 multiplied by 3x squared plus 5. And that's how we use the chain rule to peel back, like an onion, this function so that we can finally find its derivative. So that was a lot of information today. If you have any questions, please feel free to write them in the comments, and I'm happy to go over any further examples. This should give you the perfect foundation to start any calculus problem. You know all the basics of derivatives now, and you can see through these examples how they add on to each other. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like and subscribe to my channel for more fun and easy to follow math videos. I'll see you next time.